Greetings, YouTubeanauts! It's Mainelybutch coming at you on this fabulous Saturday, July the 6th. And there, over here, see it right there? That's the cute little Nola dog! Took Nola dog, smiled at us. See it smile? When you rub it like this, it smiles! Smile! Smile, Nola dog! Oh, he's even got his wine. Took her to the beach on the 4th, and she absolutely loved it. She likes to walk in the water. Did you see her little head cock when she heard the word beach? Yes, she's so damn cute. I'm half-ass watching her and half-ass filming for you. I hope you had a good 4th, too. 4th of July is, like, the number one holiday in my family, you know, that we really love to celebrate besides Christmas. And when we used to have the B&B, you know, in the big house that we had for 44 years, we had a beautiful in-ground pool that my dad built after I left the house and went into the Army. But when I came home, it was there. And, you know, I got to use it for all those years and the times that I stayed at the B&B and helped them out there. And they helped me out with a place to stay periodically when I would come back from an adventure somewhere off in other parts of this country. So, yeah, we would have these massive, massive 4th of July parties. They were the event in town, you know. It would be 100 people there, no joke. And people just loved it. My Canadian friend is texting me, and it's making me smile this morning, too. Yes, I love to hear from my friends. I really do, you know. And the telephone goes in two directions. You can call me, too, you know. I don't have to just call you. You know, I got one friend that just thinks the phone goes one way. And if she doesn't hear from me, she texts me at midnight with these fucking silly-ass jealous messages, you know, that are just dumb. You know, because of the fact that she could have picked the phone up and called me. The fact that she hasn't heard from me for 3 days doesn't mean she can't call me. What the fuck? You know my number. So, well, I may change that again soon. I hate sometimes having to change your phone number. Just a pain in the ass. But mainly Butch does it probably every 6 months just because of the fact that I don't like the idea that my phone number gets floated around too much and don't want that. So, plus, Nola gets all these weird calls from strange dogs. No, I'm only kidding. Back to the 4th of July, you know, we would have these raucous parties. Well, we haven't done that for the past couple of years because we sold the B&B in the fall of 2010. And I left and went to Virginia and Arkansas and then floated back here in June of 2011, got this place. My little bachelor box that I'm in now, which I really love, and I'm staying put, you know, staying here, so I can be close to my parents as they get older, and because I want to be here near my family, you know. I've got two brothers and two sisters younger than me, and a half a dozen, you know, adopt those sisters and brothers that mom would straggle into the family vein somewhere along the way, you know, and so I love having them around, and I love being able to reach out with the little phony bug, and I have a stupid phone, not a smartphone either. It is stupid, man. All it does is talk and text. It does not do web, okay? It does do pictures. So, yeah, and I use AT&T, so it's great being back here and doing this, but I miss those parties on the 4th of July more than anything. I really do, because they were awesome. And I miss that big in-ground pool, you know. It was just so awesome to see all those people gathered around that pool, laid out on their chairs or sitting around or diving in. The pool was always full of kids, and it was such a happy friggin' day. You know, we had a big 3-car garage that backed up to the pool, so that would be full of food, you know, all the tables and everything in there to keep everything out of the sun, and it was just a wonderful party every year, and I really miss it. But this year, we did try to pull some together. So what do? We went to Fort Foster State Park, which has a beautiful beach on the Atlantic Ocean. And Nola got to go swimming. See the little ears perk up back there? Yeah, swim, swim, swim. And she loves to be able to walk in the water that she can walk on. She's not crazy about the big white waves rolling over her at all, you know, but she did go out. You know, I went out about knee high because I figure great white sharks can't get in quite that far, you know. And if anybody knows me or has listened to my videos before, you know that I do not take kindly to having to swim in the Atlantic Ocean. A, it's full of sharks. B, it's got a lot of sharks. C, there are many different types of sharks. And D, it's freezing fucking cold. So, cold sharks. No Mainelybutch get in water. But I did wind about my knees because that, of course, Nola was only about this high. So, you know, of course, Nola was well over her head and able to swim around and did a really good job. You know, and she would ride the waves back in, which was really kind of cute. You know, you could see her sort of body surf their waves back into shoreline. We had a good time. My parents were there. My sister Deb, her husband, and girls were there. I played a really cool game of Polish horseshoes. Okay, now it's actually a real game that you can buy at the toy store. Okay, and it basically started off, evidently, from what my niece Meg tells me, as people putting two ski poles into the snow and putting beer bottles on top of the ski poles, and then you would take a frisbee and you would try to knock the beer bottle off the opponent's ski pole. The opponent had two things they could do. They could catch the frisbee, okay, you know, after it passed their pole. All right, they could catch the frisbee if it didn't knock the beer bottle off. They could catch the beer bottle if it knocked the beer bottle off. They could catch both, okay, if they were really smart and if they were playing in teams. So that's pretty hard to coordinate catching a frisbee and catching a falling beer bottle at the same time. But they make this toy in toy stores, and it's basically they give you two poles that go into the ground with little platforms on the top, and you put your little ye they have little yellow bottles that look at the shape of a beer, of a Budweiser beer bottle, you know, and that goes on top. And then they give you a nice 150 gram frisbee, which is the perfect weight if you're a frisbee player, in my opinion anyway, because I play for distance and trick stuff, and so I don't like the real tiny ones because they go even further distance and they're not good for tricks. So I like the 150s. 165 is a little heavy for me, but 150s are perfect. But they give you this 150 gram frisbee, you zap it at the damn beer bottles, and it was pretty cool game. Megan and I played for a while, and I did hit the beer bottle a few times, you know. And she hit it, you know. It's really good to do that underhand sort of this type of throw instead of this throw. This type of throw seemed to be a little more accurate for me in knocking the beer bottle off. Polish horseshoes. And it says on the box, Polish horseshoes. Poleish. Polish. I don't know. But I call it Polish horseshoes. It's a cool game. If anybody gets a chance to get it or to play it, do it. You know, you can even make it up yourself. Get some ski poles, some duct tape, make a little platform on top. I don't know how they do with ski poles. You know what I mean? They must tip the beer bottle upside down. Put the pole with the point up and put it on that way. I have no idea how you would do it with ski poles myself, because aren't ski poles got handles on one end? I don't ski, so I don't fucking know. But the one you buy at the store, that game couldn't have been more than $20. You could build one with a couple of good, you know, broomsticks from Home Depot, you know, and again, a roll of duct tape. Some tin foil or cardboard to make the platform with, and a couple of good old-fashioned Budweiser beer bottles and a nice frisbee. Anyway, yeah. I digress. I got totally off the subject. For the view live, bang, 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 bang. Fire fucking works. which Noah doesn't like. So I worked 4th of July night. I got home at about 9 o'clock. Fireworks here started around 9:30 because it's not really dark until 9:30. So I got home. I got cleaned up. I got Noli into her blanket, and we cuddled our way through the fireworks. Ran the air conditioners and fans so she could hear as little of them as possible. She did jump a few times when they were pretty close, but you know, she didn't have a major meltdown, and I was really glad to be able to be home in time for her. You know, when they started, because you know she gets really, really nervous. So anyway, yeah. So that's the story of my 4th of July. I had a really good time, you know. My friend Amanda went with us down to Fort Foster, and that was a lot of fun. And you know, the weekend before, we went down to Strawberry Festival, and did that, and I did a bunch of clips of that. I will have to put them together. They're not real great, but I'll put them together and tell you kind of a little bit about Strawberry Festival and show you some of the stupid stuff that it's not really stupid, it's fun stuff that we do here in Maine. We love our fairs and festivals, and it is fair and festival season now. All the ag fairs are gonna start teeing all the little cows and the horses and the chickens and the bunnies and all that stuff. My sister Patty's cats, big kitty, had six little kitties, and they're doing real good. They're looking awful, awful cute. So, what else is going on? Work is going well. I'm enjoying that. 4 nights a week, Wednesday through Saturday. This is really nice. I work about 5 hours a night on those 4 nights, about 20 hours a week. It's a fun job. It's fun to be out and seeing people and meeting people. I met this guy last night who sells steel, and he's up here looking at bridge construction, like the Tappan Zee in Boston, which is going to go to bid at some point for all you steel Mongols out there. Like the Memorial Bridge here, connecting Kittery, Maine to Portsmouth, New Hampshire. It's the downtown bridge. That one's coming up, getting ready to open. They built those bridge, those three pieces of that bridge. Each side has an on piece, and then the middle is a drawbridge because this is a big port here. We bring in a lot of oil. We got a big industrial side of the river that does cable. We got simplex cable and wire here. They do transatlantic type of cable, or they used to do. I don't even know if they use transatlantic cable anymore because don't we satellite most everything? Yes, we do. Maybe they'll start building satellites. We have a big drywall corporation here that manufactures most of the drywall used in North America, and they bring in the limestone and the stuff to make the drywall from Canada and bring it in on big ships and empty it out here. Plus we have power plants and we have lots of stuff on that river, so the ships have got to be able to get up and down a river. So there's the drawbridge, which I said has a piece on each end and then a middle piece that raises and lowers to let the ships through. We have two of those in a row. They're about, I don't know, 500 yards apart. One is a very small one, and that is the Memorial Bridge that connects Kittery to Portsmouth downtown areas. Very vital bridge because a lot of people would walk across to hang out at night, go to the park, go to Prescott Park Arts Festival, go down to all the restaurants, and all the nice little pubs and stuff like that there are in downtown Portsmouth. And also, it was vital to downtown Kittery's revitalization project. They're trying to build that back up. It's kind of a forgotten little downtown. We don't even use much anymore. You go down there, you got a purpose now because there's nothing really down there. The library, and that's about it. And unless you're interested in going to the library, you probably don't go to downtown Kittery very much. There's a lot of really cute little shops down there. Problem is, they need a couple of really good restaurants down there. I mean, not little fucking sandwich joints. They need some fucking restaurants. Somebody got to take a chance, and it would be a chance. It is also the front gate to the Portsmouth Naval Shipyard down there, too. So, the middle bridge is the Sarah Mildred Long Bridge. It is a longer bridge, it is newer than the old memorial was. Not anymore. The memorial is now going to be brand spank me new. And it's also a drawbridge, and it's got a railway that runs underneath it that is very vital to the Navy base. So that railway can't go away. So they're going to replace that bridge, but they're going to do it in place. In other words, they're going to build a new the Sarah Mildred Long Bridge right next to the old one so that they can keep that rail bed open for the Navy base. Vital. Gotta stay open. Gotta be able to get your nuclear stuff on and off the base. It's a nuclear submarine rehab base, so they gotta be able to transport that stuff, and they do it by train. And that's the only way across there. So they've got to keep that rail bed open. So they're gonna keep the bridge open for us to use as well. And then we have a high level bridge. A high level bridge is so fucking high that it doesn't have to go up and down. You can drive right under it with a giant ship. A pretty giant ship. I mean, I'm not sure what kind of a cruise ship would go through there, but I've seen some pretty big ass tankers go through. So yeah, so that's bridges between southern Maine and New Hampshire. And that's how you get from Maine to New Hampshire. You gotta cross a damn bridge because the Piscataquis River runs a long way up and all the rivers, we are separated by water most of the way, especially in the populated areas, down in southern Maine. Now, when you get up into a little bit of western New Hampshire, up toward the Canadian border and Maine, there's not a lot up there but trees. So, I'm not positive. I've never been up quite that high. I've never had a reason to go out into the woods up there to find out if the water is a little stream that separates the two states. But for most of the part, for most of the southern part of the state, it's all water. There is no solid land that you can walk across from one state to another. So if you're coming into Maine, you're probably going to go right by my house because I live just off of I-95. Well, it's a good place to visit. It's a great place to live. I'll talk to y'all later. Peace.